Hi guys, good morning.
How y'all doing? Welcome to another YouTube video. And today we're doing a day in the life with me. So you're gonna go through today with me, get to see what meals I have through my day. And go through what it feels like to, what a day in the life of being over 320 pounds feel like. Because at the moment we're sitting at 327 pounds. Yes, I'm only a few pounds from 330, which was the goal this offseason. But you get to come around with me today and see what it's like. And yeah, how how lazy and uncomfortable it feels. And I do use the word lazy. But anyway, we're starting off with breakfast. As usual, most of you know, my breakfast is simple and I always liked it. You got 140 grams of oats. I got the timing right. Close enough. A little extra. A little extra, never help nobody. Plus, as usual, I'm gonna put one scoop of whey isolate, which I use to my carb sources here for my breakfast. So I'm gonna whip that up and then whip up the 5 eggs as well. Your breakfast. Go on. Well, help yourself. Don't stand there drooling on my leg. It ain't getting any better. That's what you have. That's what you do. Looking at it thinking it's gonna change and get better.
Yeah.
Right, so normal morning I'll normally come down and get the breakfast done for the whole family as Mel does cardio. But at the moment we are about what, another 4 weeks before prep kicks off. So she's the one doing the cardio at the moment. I ain't started none of that. I ain't been looking forward to that doing any cardio either. So I get to whip up breakfast. So I have 5 eggs. Mel has 2. So I just add it all together. And make 7 eggs. Scrambled. And after I'm done all this, she's normally down and ready to eat. And then the dogs get sorted. He gets sorted out with his. When he's finished with his, he starts looking for ours. So, yeah. Another morning. Another living. Oh. Normal breakfast. I got my 5 eggs. 150 grams of, 140 grams of oats. They're about. And, you know, 2 eggs.
2 eggs, 40 grams of oats.
Mm-hmm. And normally, I run to my vitamins. My mail normally gives to me. She just slams it and says, take this. She doesn't tell me what it is.
Yes.
She never tells me what it is. What is it?
2 pills of ecstasy. 2 amphetamines.
Alright. That's why I'm acting all funny all day.
1 cocaine. And 3 diazepams.
Alright.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, no wonder I feel great.
Now, we've got vitamin C. Vitamin C, we've got St. John's Wort. That's to keep him calm throughout the day. It's a herbal thing, so it's not like he's off the walls, it's just to keep him calm. I think there's two water tablets, taurine, that's what you got from advice. Glucosamine for joints, and I think that's it. And that's it, yeah. So two each because of the size of this man.
Alright, so just getting my second meal of the day ready, and what we have is 450 grams of sweet potatoes, obviously cooked weight.
Well, you're not throwing this straight in the bin?
I'm throwing it in this bin after I get them all
ready. Yeah, but it makes the worktop untidy.
Alright.
And sticky.
Well, it makes me go stop going back and forth either.
No, what I do, I have my bin ready.
This is the way I do it.
Because it's here underneath, and then you just basically make it much more easier.
This
make it harder and more dirty.
This is the way I do it. As I was saying, 450 grams of sweet potatoes and 250 steak.
200
steak. Not 250 chicken. And like I said before, we normally pre-cook our chicken. Yeah, of course, yeah,
and beef.
Our beef and all our protein sources. And we have them just already bagged, so we just pretty much get them out.
Is this 40?
Yeah, it's 460, close enough. Close enough. I don't know, mess around with one single potato.
No, it just for me it looks like it's only like 300.
No, it's 450.
My bad.
Okay. And then what happens is after I get this meal down, 20 minutes after, I have a shake with it. And I'll do that with my next 2-3 meals of the day. So
there we go.
Nice barbecue steak right there.
Yeah.
That goes in the microwave. And I get a meal now. Now at this stage of the prep, really.
No prep.
I mean, at this stage of the off season, really, you know, the amount of food we're eating, you're not really have an appetite for food, man. You know, I know a lot of people say like, you know, they struggle to eat that much food or anything like that. But you have to sort of master the art of, just being able to get the food down you. It's no longer about enjoyment, it's no longer about taste. It's just more of a job of what you gotta do, and that's what it is. So the more you can more or less master that art of being able to just eat food and put it down you without concentrating too much on taste and flavor and everything else, the better off you'll be. Now, especially when, you know, people always say, oh, but the same meal they saw, feel like it's repetitive from day to day. But the thing is, it's all about consistency. It's all about being able to consistently eat the same sort of food and get the same nutrition over and over, day in and day out. If you can manage that, you're in good stead. So, yeah.
Who is it prepared for? So,
prepared by yours truly.
Who's that?
Well, you know, I didn't state.
Was that like individual effort or collective effort?
It's a collective effort.
Exactly. Thank
Mind you,
you
had
so,
our...
So, who's cooking potatoes?
I was going to say, we had our breakfast at 8 o'clock, 8:30 today, which normally time roughly we have our breakfast.
Are you changing the subject?
And then the second meal we have about, 11 o'clock.
Your juice is in my camera.
No. Go to one of these.
You're not mentioning that,
you're
a bit of a junk.
I always have juices, man. Juices, smoothie.
In the off season?
Yep. As the calories. Go to a bottle of that a day. To make up the calories. Only during the meal though. This is my international barber. You know, he's been taking care of me for the last, what, month now?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. And man really hooks me up every time I come in, man. And the guy says, like, first I come in, what do you say about, mom was like, dude, you're big, man.
Yeah, you're massive.
He's like,
you're massive. Seriously.
Well, he's the guy that takes care of me the most, but yeah. He definitely hooks me up every time.
Mm-hmm.
So I come in, I've been coming in every 2 weeks.
Get what's the name of it? Place?
SS Barber's Lounge.
Essex Barber's Lounge.
Yeah.
And that's in Chelmsford.
That's right.
Chelmsford, Essex.
Yeah, that's right.
Just next to the train station.
Essex Barber's Lounge. Okay, so this is before.
Yep.
And then we'll do after as well.
You're gonna make me look pretty again.
That's right.
Sexy look here. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to drop my game now.
Yeah, okay.
Nice.
Okay, have a look.
Nice. Looking good, right?
How
am I gonna look? Mm-hmm. See, my man's good, right? See, that's why I come here. My man's the best.
Okay.
Yeah. Can you do it?
Yeah, thanks, yeah.
No problem, man. Cool. Alright, so just getting ready to head up to the gym, got a shoulder workout to get done today. Doing my post-workout shake. So what I have is 2 scoops of ISO H1 and 2 scoops of clostridexin car powder to add to it. Nice. And that's my post-workout shake. And then intro workout, I have my intro workout drink mixed in with Bloodshot. Have that both mixed in there with water, and I'm going to drink that throughout the whole workout. Then before we head out, before we get training anyway, I'm going to have my third meal of the day, which I'm going to get packed up now. Probably have it on the way to the gym, which is pasta and mince, and I'm going to show you a measurement of that in a minute. But let me get my gym bits ready. We can get on. So I'm just putting my third meal together, which is going to be my speed gym meal today. And what we have is 300 grams of pasta and 180 grams of lean mince. So pretty much spaghetti bolognese for some.
This is mixed with bolognese sauce.
Yeah, so it's just pretty much spaghetti bolognese. And I'm having that pre-workout, one of us will get on our way to the gym. And then when I finish eating that, I'm going to have another shake, which is right there. And then I'm going to get to work, training. Oh yeah. So, get the meal set up and get on the road with it. And get to training. Yes. Yeah. Thank you. Guys, so I'm just having my post-gym meal now, which is 2 cups of rice and 250 grams of chicken breast, and then I'm having my shake as well. Now with my post-gym shake, one or two things that happen. If I'm a long way from home, I'll have a shake before I get home, but if I'm quite close to home, I'll have a meal first and then I'll have the shake afterwards. But
so what was the case in this
today? I was close to home, so
you're close to home.
So yeah, so I'm having a shake right after the meal, but that's our next one. It's in chicken breast and rice. Nice.
I'm cooking rice. I have to be running out. We have to cook a lot of rice for you. Yes. How about for your eyes? Wash it. See? Clean it. Then I put boiling water. As you see.
How do you wash it?
How do I wash it?
Why?
Why? To get rid of the starch. the stickiness part of it. We don't like sticky rice. So what we do on top of that, mm-hmm. you get some coconut oil inside, and it gives it a nice crispy flavor. You like it like that, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Good for you. So that's what we do, like that. And then you mix it up, you sort of separate the rice as much as possible, and when it's going to be cooking, it's not going to end up being very sticky. It's going to be nice, very nice. So what we do, we've got a function here for rice, but we only cook it for 25 minutes because I've put boiling water in. That's all it takes, 25 minutes.
All right, I made a mistake of telling Mel about the tortilla challenge.
Yes.
And now she's forced me to play this.
Yes.
With her.
Yes. I agree.
No, don't ever tell your other
it's
half
fun.
About this game.
Fun.
Or whatever this is. Don't ever tell them because they force you to play it. No, don't do it. But anyway, we're gonna play.
Okay. Here we go.
Alright, let me explain.
Okay,
so,
go.
This is the tortilla challenge take one. Drink.
Thank you.
Drink, drink, drink. So we're coming down to my fifth meal of the day, and it's exactly the same as my fourth meal. We got two cups of rice and 250 grams of chicken breasts. So I told me to have them three portions. And microwave, let's keep going.
That looks delicious.
That's my thing. My barbecue grill, you don't know about that. I don't know about my barbecue.
Yeah, you hate this chicken.
Huh?
You hate this chicken.
Yeah, I don't really like. At least why I don't really like the chicken breast much. Sad to say that. But I know the appetite comes for it in the prep. But this is my. This is my heart.
Done.
Yeah. Very true. Right, so. Last meal of the evening. That's a sick one, and it's just helping salmon.
Is that all for you, for one meal?
No, that's not for me. Yes. That's 200 grams of salmon just for me. The rest of them is for the rest of the family.
Thank you.
Just like the first meal of the day, you know?
Thank you. Do you mind not overspicing?
I'm not overspicing. Excuse me. This is my thing.
I'm a professional.
I'm what I do. I'm a professional at this. This is my expertise. So don't you worry so much. So once it's seasoned up, it goes in the air fryer.
Mm-hmm.
For about 17 minutes. And it'll be all done. Mm-hmm. Yes. It takes a grill.
Look, it smells on me.
Hmm?
I can smell it.
Strong.
Very strong.
It will smell like the sea.
It smells like a sea.
It's supposed to smell like the sea.
Fish smells like fish.
No, it doesn't smell like a sea. It means that it's on the back end of the base.
Oh, this one's a hot one, so just please reserve it for you.
What I'm doing.
Oh, okay. So what are these?
Chili flakes. See?
Yes.
Just like my stuff a little bit hot. Anybody else?
Exactly the same, but I was thinking, okay,
if I ask you,
is that going to look very cringy in the video? Yes. So, how was your day?
It's alright.
Another day. Funny enough, we have the same thing going from our mind. Mm-hmm. Because I'm thinking, okay, do I say something about the salmon that is lovely? Or do I ask you, how was your day? But then I'm thinking, is it going to be so, tacky and cringy for the video.
Yep, you would have
been. But it would be.
That's what I do.
Yes. This is a very nice salmon.
Is it?
Yes.
Yeah,
you've got some very good cooking skills, my friend.
I know. Well, I'm not too fast about it.
You're not too fast about it?
No.
Your own salmon.
And stuff, that's why.
Mm-hmm. No, I'm talking about mine. It's
Yeah, it was nice.
Cool. Very nice, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
I appreciate it.
Indeed.
Lovely.